Welcome back to English class. In today's session, we'll be doing English 1, Lesson 5, Aboli Counsels, Donkeys. Okay? So, this is Lesson 5, Aboli Counsels, Donkeys, page number 28. Okay, children? I'll be doing the lesson reading. I'll explain the whole chapter and also we'll do the textbook exercises part of it. Okay? This is a very small chapter. Okay? All of you open your textbooks, page number 28.
Abu Ali counts his donkey. One day, Abu Ali went to the fair to buy some donkeys. He bought 9 donkeys from the fair. He rode on one of them and the rest of the donkeys followed him. After he had travelled a mile, Abu Ali thought that he must count his donkeys. I must make sure all of them are here. He turned around to count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, where is the 9th donkey? Abu Ali cried.
Okay, so what happens here, children? There's a traveler by name called as Abu Ali. Okay, the traveler's name is Abu Ali. You can see here now. Here's Abu Ali and these are his donkeys. Okay? So, what happened? Abu Ali goes to a fair. Okay? He goes to a fair to buy some donkeys. Fair. What do you mean by fair, children? Fair is a place where you buy things. Okay, where you buy things or where you buy and sell goods. Okay, like just an exhibition. You see, you know, exhibitions where they sell all kinds of clothes, accessories, okay, household items, and you also have games over there. Correct? No, you all go. So, same way, fair is a place just like an exhibition. Fair is just like an exhibition. Where you buy and sell goods. Okay? So, Abu Ali, he went to a fair to buy some donkeys. Abu Ali wanted some donkeys. So, he went to buy some donkeys. And he bought 9 donkeys. How many donkeys did he buy? He bought 9 donkeys from the fair. Then what he did? He rode on one of them and the rest of the donkeys followed him. So, Abu Ali sat on one donkey. Okay? The first donkey, Abu Ali sat. Okay? This is the donkey one. On the donkey one, Abu Ali sat. And then donkey 2, donkey 3, donkey 4, donkey 5, donkey 6, donkey 7, donkey 8, donkey 9. They all followed like this. Correct? He sat on the first donkey and all the donkeys followed like this. Okay? Next, after he had traveled a mile, Abu Ali thought that he must count his donkeys. Okay, after traveling for certain time, okay, after like 1 hour or 2 hours something, after some time, he thought, okay, let me count the donkeys and see whether the donkeys are coming behind me or not. Okay, then he turned back, sitting on this donkey, he turned back and he started counting. He counted from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now he is like, how come there are only 8 donkeys? Where is the 9th donkey? Abu Ali forgot to count this donkey because he was sitting on this donkey and he forgot to count this donkey. He started counting from here. So it came only 8 donkeys. Now he is worried where is the 9th donkey.
He jumped down from the donkey. He looked everywhere behind the rock, around the trees, but he could not find his donkey. Let me count it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Oh, God is great. My donkey has come back, exclaimed Abu Ali. So, Abu Ali climbed his donkey again and continued his journey. After riding a few more miles, he decided to count his donkeys once again. To his dismay, there were only 8. So, again he looked around everywhere in all places possible. Above the great rock, below the rock, even inside a bush.
Okay, so again what Abu Ali did, he counted. When he counted, it was how many donkeys? 8 donkeys. Now he is very much confused. What is this? I got 9 donkeys, there are only 8 donkeys. Then he gets down from the donkey. Okay, he gets down and he searches, starts searching everywhere. He searches under the rock, he searches near the trees, everywhere in his surroundings, he starts searching. Okay, still he couldn't find his donkeys. Then he thinks, okay, let me count again. And now he counts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now it is how many donkeys? 9 donkeys. Now he is happy. He will say, oh God, God is really great. My donkey has come back. Was the donkey lost? No, it was not lost. He had forgotten to count his donkey. Now he got down from the donkey and he started counting everything. So there are 9 donkeys. He thinks the donkey has come back. The lost donkey has come back and God has sent the donkey back. Okay? So again what he do? He again sit on the donkey. He will again sit on this donkey and he will start this journey. Okay? Again after some time, he will think, okay, now again I have to count my donkeys. Now he will again start counting from here. He will turn back and he will start counting from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many donkeys are here again? 8. He will again count 8 donkeys. Again he is worried. Okay? Again he will think that, oh God, where did my one more donkey go? Again there is only 8 donkeys. And he is very, very disappointed. Okay? Here you can see dismay. Dismay, no children. Underline dismay in your textbook. Okay? To his dismay. Okay? The last line here you have to his dismay. There were only 8. Okay? To his dismay. You can see dismay here, no? Yes. Here, underline this. Dismay is nothing but disappointed. Okay? Dismay is nothing but disappointment. So now again there are only 8 donkeys and he is still worried.
How is that possible? Surprised. He scratched his head. It was a puzzle. The more he thought, the more confused he became. Just then he saw his friend Musa walking along the road. He called him, "Oh Musa, help me count my donkeys. When I turned around to count, there are 8. But when I get down to look for the 9th, he is always there," he said. Musa laughed loudly. "Abu Ali, I can see 10 donkeys." 10? How can you see 10? I want only 9, asked poor Abu Ali. He was so confused. "I can see 8 donkeys behind you and you are sitting on the 9th one," Musa answered. "Of course," cried Abu Ali. "How stupid of me, but where is the 10th donkey?" "He is sitting on the top of the 9th donkey and his name is Abu Ali," said Musa and walked away.
Okay, so what happened? Again he turned back and he see and there are only 8 donkeys. Now again he is worried, he is confused, he doesn't know what to do. And when he is thinking all this with all these emotions in him, suddenly he finds his friend Musa. Okay, his friend, his name is Musa. You can see here, no? This guy
is Abu Ali's friend called as Musa.
Okay? Musa comes. Abu Ali is quite happy now seeing him. And he'll tell his problems to him. "See Musa, now I bought 9 donkeys from the fair, but when I turn back and count, there are only 8 donkeys. Now when I get down from the donkey and search everywhere and then start to count the donkeys, there are 9 donkeys. How is it possible? How can this be?" Then Musa will get to know that Abu Ali was just being foolish. Okay? So he'll say, Yeah, I understand now. There are no 9 donkeys, there are 10 donkeys. So Abu Ali is again confused. 10 donkeys? How can there be 10 donkeys? I bought only 9 donkeys. So he'll say, "See, behind you there are 8 donkeys. Okay? And you are sitting on one donkey, which is 9 donkey." Then Abu Ali will realize, "Oh, correct. I was sitting on the first donkey, no? And I forgot to count the donkey." So he'll say, Yes, correct. How foolish am I? Okay? I've been so foolish to not count the donkey I was sitting on. So there are 9 donkeys. Then again he'll ask, "Yes, now there are 9 donkeys. How come you said there are 10 donkeys?" Musa will say, "The 10th donkey is sitting on the 9th donkey." Okay, so the 10th donkey is sitting on the one and he laughed loudly. It means indirectly saying that Abu Ali is also as foolish as a donkey itself. Okay? So this completes your chapter, children. This is a very short and sweet story. This is about how Abu Ali was foolish enough. Okay? That's all. So now all of you turn to page number 30. Okay?
Turn to page number 30. Okay? Here you can see word bank, right? That is dismay. Dismay is nothing but disappointed. Confused. Confused is mixed up. Okay? Mixed up is
you don't know what to do, okay? What to think, how to think, you don't know. That is confused. Next, puzzle. Puzzle is riddle. Puzzles, you know, you all have puzzles at your home, right? Riddles. Okay, you ask a question and you have to think about some answer. It's
Next, stupid, foolish. Okay,
stupid means you know how foolish it is, right? Apollo was so foolish to not count the donkey he was sitting on.
Next, take the correct options. Which word suits Abuali the best? Clever, wise, foolish. What is the correct answer? Foolish. Tick here. Tick foolish. Next, Musa was Abuali's teacher, friend, enemy. What was Musa? Musa was Abuali's friend. Next, Musa laughed at Abuali's intelligence, cleverness, or foolishness? Foolishness. Next, this will go in your classwork. Now here, vocabulary. Look at these words. Something, daytime, everyone. Each one is made up of two words but written as a single word. Are the following words written as a single or two words? Write them in the correct boxes. Check your answers in the dictionary. Okay, here you have some words here. Okay, these are two words. Okay, some are actually meaning it is a single word, but some are two words combined together. You can see here something. Some is a word, thing is a word, right? So it is two words. Okay, here day, time. Day is also a separate word, time is also a separate word. Every, one. Every is a separate word, one is a separate word, but it is attached as a single word, correct? Same way you have some more words here. Keyboard, ice cube, junk food, lunchtime, egg cup, haircut, living room, car park, keyhole, lipstick, film star, daylight. Okay? You should check whether these words are a single word or it is combination of two words or not. And you have to write here. Okay? This you can check in your dictionary whether it is a single word or a two words. Now you have to write here, children. First one they have given for you here, right? They have given keyhole. Keyhole is a one word. It is not two words. It's a single word. Okay? Then keyboard. Keyboard is also a single word. Lunchtime. Right? Lunchtime. It is also a single word. Haircut. Lipstick. Daylight. You have to write here like this, children. Okay? Next. Two words. Which are the words? Which are two words joined together? Car. Park. Ice cube, junk food, egg cup, living room, film star. These are two words joined together. Okay, these doesn't have a single word, but these are a single word. Okay, finish this, children. You have to finish this here. Now come to page number 32. Okay, creative writing. Write a short paragraph comparing human beings to ants. To compare, you may use and. And to contrast, you may use but. Contrast means writing the difference. Writing the difference is called as contrast. As shown in two sentences below, human beings and ants are similar in some ways and different in few. Both human beings and ants live together in their communities or colonies. Every human community, there are leaders and managers. But in ant colonies, there are no leaders or managers. Same way, they have written some similarities and some differences, right? For similarities, you have to write and. For differences, you have to use but. Okay? So, I have written here. I want you also to write the same, children. Write the same in your... Okay, children. So, this I told you. See how I have written here? Yes, I have written here, no? Same thing I have written on the board. See here, children. Human work hard for living luxurious life and ants work hard to save food for the winter. Ants are very disciplined but humans are big. Ants are very disciplined. Humans are big but ants are small. Human beings and ants have their own ways for communication. See, when I'm telling about the similarities, I use and. When I'm telling the differences, I use but. Okay? Please copy this, children. Copy this in the place. Okay, children. This completes your chapter lesson 5, Abuali Counts Donkeys. Okay? I've read the chapter. I've explained you the lesson. The lesson is very simple. Okay? I'll just give a recap for you again. Okay? So, one day there was a person called as... Okay? So,
once there was a person called as Abu Ali. Okay, he wanted to buy 9 donkeys. So he goes to a fair and he buys 9 donkeys for him. Okay, he sits on the first donkeys and he makes all the other 8 donkeys to follow him. While he is traveling, okay, after traveling for some time, he thinks that, okay, now I should start counting my donkeys to see whether all are following me or not. And he turns back and he'll come, he'll see that there are only 8 donkeys because he forgets to count the donkey he is sitting on. Then he'll be wondering, how come there are 8 donkeys? I want 9 donkeys. So how come there are only 8 donkeys? Then he'll get down from the donkey and he'll start searching under the rock, near the bushes, behind the bushes, near the tree, around the tree, everywhere he'll start searching, but he can't find anything. So he'll turn back and he'll count again. He'll say, okay, let me count again, and he counts all the donkeys. Now there are 9 donkeys. So he'll be worried, how come there were 8 donkeys? Now how come there was 9 donkeys already? Okay, maybe God has, you know, God has given, sent the donkey back. Okay, God has sent me the 9th donkey and it is back. And he again sits on the donkey and he starts traveling. Again, after traveling a certain distance, he thinks that, okay, now I should count my donkeys. And he'll turn back and he counts only 8 donkeys. Now again, he's worried. He is disappointed. He doesn't know what to do. Array, when I get down and count, there are 9 donkeys. When I sit and count, turn back and count, there are only 8 donkeys. How is it possible? He'll be thinking. And then suddenly he finds his friend whose name is Musa. And he'll call Musa and he'll tell him the problem to Musa. Musa will start laughing at the foolishness of Abu Ali. He'll say, yes, Abu Ali, there are 8 donkeys, there are 10 donkeys, not 9 donkeys. Abu Ali is like, how come 10 donkeys? I bought only 9 donkeys. So Musa will say, see, behind you there are 8 donkeys and you are sitting on the 9th donkey. Then Abu Ali realized, oh yes, the donkey what I was sitting on, I did not count the donkey. So that is how it is. Then Abu Ali will ask, okay, now there are 9 donkeys, but you said 10 donkeys, how come? So he'll say, there is the 10th donkey sitting on the 9th donkey, and he'll start laughing. Okay? So this is just a display of a foolishness of Abu Ali. That's all, children. This is the smallest story, the smallest chapter for you. Please complete, read the textbook, read the lesson, and please do your textbook exercises part of it completed. Okay? And still, if you have any doubt, we'll meet on the interactive session. Okay? Thank you, children.